In Islam, there have been many, many sects throughout the history. Some of those sects, they arose as a result of political problems, and some of them came as a result of philosophical thinking and questions raised by religious groups within Muslim societies. It is very important to study these sects because they are part of the history, and also very often in Islamic sources, one finds reference to those sects. For example, Khawarij, Shia, Mu'tazila, Murji'a, Qadariya, Jahmiya, all these sects, they are very often referred in the sources. If one has no idea about them, it is very difficult to understand, you know, discussions in those texts. Once people learn about these sects and differences and they understand their arguments properly, and also they understand the arguments of the Salaf who have been refuting and engaging with these sects, it will help us in modern time. Many those ideas and those questions which have been raised by the people in the past, they keep coming, sometimes with a name, new names, sometimes with the same names. Generally, when we study the Aqeedah and we study the differences among the sects, it is not only historical, its benefit certainly continues. Because many of those ideas which people have, they keep coming. And also it actually helps us to understand how to teach people Islamic sciences deeply and properly, so they can be saved from the so many misunderstandings. When we look in the arguments of many of these sects, it is very clear that their knowledge of the Quran and their knowledge of the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is very superficial. Quran and Sunnah, they comprehend the life of the believer in every aspect of their life, in the peace and the war and so many things. These people, they pick up some verses which actually belong to the time of the war, and they apply to those times when there is a need for a community to be peace and to engage with other communities. In the past, Khawarij, they were known that to rebel against the established rulers and established order. For their own misunderstanding of the Quran. This thing we have seen in our time has become so big. Young Muslims, they are so convinced by these ideas, and they think the only way to engage with the established regimes and with the non-Muslims is just to fight or to kill them, and they justify their action by using the same verses of the Quran which have been used by the early Khawarij. So once we understand those sects and we understand how the Salaf have been engaging with them, it will make easier for us to understand these new sects, and also it will help us how to save the young generation from joining them and from being convinced with them.